Hey everybody, so today I'm going to do a review on the powders that I use, and two of them are from NYX and two are from e.l.f. So let me start by doing the one from NYX. So the first one is the Stay Matte But Not Flat Powder Foundation. This one is an SMP08 in golden beige, and it looks like this. The other one is the NYX Twin Cake Powder, and this is in CP13 in Perfect Tan, and this one has SPF 10. And this one looks like this. This one is a little bit bigger than the Twin Cake powder, but also this one is bulkier than smaller. So I think in some ways it evens it out. And this one has a shiny black plastic, while this one has like a matte finish type of plastic right here. When I open this one, there's a mirror right here. And this is the product. I feel like there's a lot of product in here. And when you flip this pan right here, there is a spot for a sponge, but I don't use sponges. I usually mostly use brushes. So I might just have to actually take this one out, which I will do right now. So that's what it looks like. And this one has the same type of arrangement, only the mirror in here goes underneath. So this is where the sponge used to be at, but I took it out since I don't use it. And now the mirror is underneath right here when you flip it, and there's the product. And side by side, as far as color wise, they're pretty similar, I want to say. So the NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat Foundation is a matte finish powder that provides a natural looking but lightweight coverage, and it also is supposed to make your complexion look flawless. This one has nylon 12 and silica, and silica is mostly found in powders like the high definition powders. It's supposed to make your skin look flawless and pretty much like a photo finish look. This one, on the other hand, it's a micro milled press powder. So basically what that does to your skin is it evens out uneven skin tones if you have, you know, different, I guess, colorations on your face and stuff like that. It reduces shine. And again, I guess it's also picture perfect finish, whatever that means. It's got SPF 10. It's non-comedogenic, which means that all the ingredients does not contribute to the growth of acne. And it's also best used for high humidity, and you can use it with a dry or a damp sponge or brush or whatever applicators that you use. So they are pretty, I want to say, they are pretty well milled products in my opinion. So I feel that they offer light to medium coverage, like I said. So I don't use this on its own. I know this one says it's a foundation, but I usually use it on top of my tinted moisturizer. I don't have oily skin, but if you do, I heard that the Twin Cake powder is awesome if you have oily skin, especially they said that it's really good for hot weather, humid weather. So you might want to try this one. Again, a lot of this is my own personal preference because of the type of skin that I have and the type of coverage that I'm looking for. As far as lasting ability, I've never had any problems with it. I mean, like I said, I use it to top over my tinted moisturizer. Maybe if you use a setting spray over it, it will make it last long. The other two that I'm reviewing are the same kind but different colors that I actually purchased because I made a mistake, because they were only available online. And I used to use them and I used to like them, but now I want to say that this would have to be my new favorites. These are actually my backups for my Sephora Mattifying Powder Foundation, but I do use this quite a bit too. Even though they're backups, I just like to use them because it works really well for my skin. So the other two I'm going to talk about is e.l.f. pressed powder, and they look like this. And the studio version of e.l.f. is well known for the little window that they have. The black packaging, very sleek, very sturdy. Everyone says that it's similar to NARS. I don't have any NARS cosmetics, but I've seen some packaging and it does kind of look the same, only NARS doesn't have this window, and obviously NARS has their brand on the outside. And when you open it, you have a mirror. And this is the product. And there is a sponge underneath it. I don't use this, as you can tell. I haven't touched it at all. And if you look, there really is not much product in there. It's really very thin right here, this pan right here. This has a really silky smooth formula, in my opinion, and it's really good for touch-ups. And also, I think this should just be used over tinted moisturizer or a foundation, just to kind of add on to color. However, I feel like the powder is denser than the NYX ones that I talked about because it's not finely milled. Again, something that happens a lot with e.l.f. products are they're a little bit on a chalky side, powdery, dusty, however you want to call it. I know for me it's not a problem because I could easily mix it just because of my skin tone and my skin type. However, for a lot of you, if you have oily skin, you might not want a powder that's so chalky. That's gonna get stuck and get clogged on your pores. So that's something to just kind of consider and think about when you're purchasing this one. So this isn't caramel, and this is an almond. An almond is the one that's a little bit more closer to my skin than caramel, but I could definitely work caramel, no problem. But this one does not seem to have a lot of fallout, and when I did a review on this, or like a, not a full-blown review, I think in passing I mentioned that this specific color that I got in caramel, it's comparable to my Clinique Perfectly Real powder makeup, and I couldn't really tell the difference, and I couldn't tell the difference. However, on this one, I could really tell the difference because this has more chalky, more powdery. I can control it. However, I feel like e.l.f. has some quality control issue because I don't think that it's very similar in terms of consistency in this particular powder that I have right now. So I'm going to swatch them for you guys, and again, I'll take photos so that you can see them. It's a little bit harder to see as far as the color in there. And then it also swatches very differently in my hand. And it seems like the back of our hands are always lighter than our faces. That is my review of these powders. I don't use this as much. I actually use this just to bring for travel because they're cheap. So if it breaks or anything like that, or I lose it, then I won't have to be so sad about losing or breaking them. So anyway, that's my review, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.